Morning. Today is October 2nd. Today is the first school day of October. You may start to see some spookiness creep into the halls of Kingsley Junior High as Halloween draws near. Let's get you caught up. Now here is Emma with your local weather.
Hi, I'm Emma, and here is Kingsley weather. We have warmer weather in the low 80s and a little cloudy. No need for coats. Over to you, Myron.
Hi, I'm Myron, and here are your Kingsley birthdays. Over the weekend, Skyla S., Theodore S., Trevor D., Molly N., Ty Z., Caden F., and Margaret C. celebrated birthdays. Today, let's wish Marion A. a happy birthday. Be sure to send birthday wishes to Kylie C., Caitlin G., Jason M., Baze B., Holly L., Grayson B., Evelyn C., and Liani M.K. and Fallon T. Our Kingsley staff birthdays are Mr. Thompson, Mrs. Stuckey, Miss Stuckey, Mrs. Adams, Mr. Armhire. Over to you, Luke.
Hello, this is Luke, and here is this week's lunch menu. Today we're going to be having a chicken pie sandwich. On Tuesday, we're going to be having popcorn chicken, a mashed potato bowl, and a biscuit. On Wednesday, you can have a cheeseburger or a hamburger. On Thursday, you can have a walking taco with cheese, with baked Doritos, and with salsa. On Friday, you can have mini cinnamon rolls with cheese omelets. Wildcat cookies come with all lunches on Friday. Have a great lunch, Kingsley. Over to you, Kelsey.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to this week's segment of Book Corner. Today, I'll be talking about a book that I read called Calvin and Hobbes. Calvin and Hobbes is a comic book about a boy in school who has a stuffed tiger named Hobbes that he thinks is an actual tiger. Join Calvin and his pet tiger and Calvin and Hobbes in their amazing adventures. You can find this book in the IMC or your Lane Comp teacher's classroom.
Hi, I'm Pearl.
And I'm Amaya.
And we're filling in for Mahadia for fun facts.
This is the weekly trivia. A phone has 10 times more bacteria than a toilet seat. The Tower of Pisa is 850 years old.
Monday is the most stressful day of the week.
Wyoming is the least populated state.
If you vomit and your vomit looks like coffee grounds, go to the ER immediately. You have blood in your throat.
Over to you, Tegan.
Tegan for your Kingsley Sports. The Kingsley cross country team ran at sectionals over the weekend. Here's a list of those who participated. The Kingsley girls basketball team continues to roll. Last Tuesday, both the 7th and 8th grade girls defeated their crosstown rivals, Chittix. The 7th grade girls defeated Glenwood. But unfortunately, the 8th graders lost. 7th grade Kingsley reporter Lorena sat down with three of the members of our Kingsley baseball team. Here is what they had to say.
Hi, my name is Lorena. I am from Kingsley News, and we have the three baseball players here. Question one. What was your favorite part of the baseball season this year?
At the end of the year, we got to do a home run derby.
Okay. Question two. How did Kingsley do? What was your record?
Our 7th grade team went 13-4-1, and our 8th grade team went 12-6-3.
Question three, who would you consider the MVP this year?
I would say Brock did the best this year.
Okay. Question four, what was your best comeback to win?
So we were down 6-0 against Chittix, and we got back up because Joey was pitching a perfect game, and we got our hits back.
Question five, who was the hardest team you played?
Chatham. They could hit the ball. Their pitching was really good, and they went undefeated this year.
Question six, what did you look forward to for this year, next year?
I look forward to
Over to you, Kelsey.
Here are some announcements. Unhappy with your picture? Did you blink, have a stain on your shirt, or were you simply having a bad hair day? never fear. Picture retakes will be this Wednesday, October 4th. This week is our spirit week for Normal Community West's homecoming. Be sure to dress up to show your spirit. Here are the themes for the days. Monday is Sports Team Day. Tuesday is Tie-Dye Tuesday. Wednesday is Superhero Day. And Thursday is Neon Day. And Friday is Kingsley Spirit Wear Day. At last Tuesday's student council meeting, the following students were voted on the 23-24 Student Council Executive Board. President Ginny Freeman, 8th grade. Vice President Aaron Shirer, 7th grade. Historian Kaden Crew, 7th grade. And Secretary Rudy Compton, 6th grade. Please join us in congratulating these students on their achievements. Mrs. Riley would like to thank all of the staff members who wrote letters of recommendation and helped students during their run for office. This year's council is 37 students strong. Your letters, emails, and words of encouragement are meaningful and deeply appreciated by council members. KJHS yearbook is starting up tomorrow. Last year, the Kingsley yearbook was brought to national attention due to the quality of writing and photos that appeared in the yearbook. Yearbook representative of 25 years, Jim Hawkinson, said, At the middle school, junior high level, we just simply don't see this kind of a book put together. Your staff continues to impress me with your ability and put together such a great book. The Kingsley yearbook staff is looking to build on previous success in creating the book celebrating 20 years of KJHS. Come to the meeting tomorrow in room 26 from 3:45 to 4:15 to find out how you can join this amazing team. If you can't make it, please email Mr. Tanner if you are interested in joining the yearbook staff. The first Books and Bites of the year is this Wednesday during each lunch. Watch for Mrs. Knowles as you head into the cafeteria to get a pass. Go to the front of the lunch line, get your food, and then report to the IMC to hear about spooky books from the Bloomington and Normal Teen Libraries. Tech Club meets Tuesday, October 3rd in room 901 from 3:45 to 4:45. The Animal Health and Wellness Club will meet the first and third each month. The first and third Monday of each month starting today. The Crochet Knitting Club will meet the first and third of Thursday of each month starting this Thursday. Drama Club met last week. So many kids came out. We are excited to see what they come up with. 100 Years of Broadway was an amazing success, and this year we are sure they will put on a truly magical performance. This has been Kelsey's Corner.